Hello learners, good morning. I am Narender Kumar Chauhan, Senior Assistant Librarian, Dr. Bhim Rao Ambedkar Library, Guru Jimbeshwar University of Science and Technology, Hisar. Today, we are going to discuss understanding plagiarism and its deterrence tools, need of the hour for academic and research community. Yes, a university professor wrote an expressive message to his students at the doctorate, master's and bachelor's levels and placed it at the entrance in the university in South Africa. Collapsing any nation does not require use of atomic bombs or the use of long-range missiles. It is only requires lowering the quality of education and allowing cheating in the examinations by the students. So, now we will discuss about the topic that what is the meaning of the plagiarism and where it has been started. Since inception of the academic societies in all over the world, the India was the home palace of every level education system even till today. However, the education was imparted through Gurukul. The pupils were generally used to stay inside the Gurukul till completion of their education. During their Diksha, the Guru was only the single voice or instrument who was responsible to impart the education to pupils. The Guru was performed alone without any assistance like teaching aids, books and written materials. The purpose of the education was to develop the character, mental power, reasoning. Education implies discipline and cultivation of the intellect. An intellect able to operate well in all fields. It enables the individual to know himself. Gradually, the Guruvani started to accumulate in the form of Dharma Grantha and literature started to publish. However, for preserving the thoughts, limited resources were available. Sources to preserve the knowledge in eon days at the initial stage, the papyrus was used for recording the thoughts, parchment of or the skin of the animals, principally those of sheep and goat was also used, yelem, or the skin of lamb or kid was used for expensive writings, while for messages and notes, wax-coated wooden tablets. The recorded and accumulated knowledge was accessible to particular group of people for a limited period of time. With the passage of time, the orientation of the education has got changed. Even new preserving tools have been introduced and emerged. During the latter half of the 14th century, the term library was defined in the Oxford English Dictionary as a place where books were kept for reading, study and reference. By the 19th century, the word library denoted a room, set of rooms and building containing collection of books for the use of public. Simply, library came to be regarded as a public institution. Commenting on the role of library in society, G.S. Sierra writes, "The library is a product of our cultural maturation. Though the concept of library came into existence, but the access of the library and its material was limited. Even the concerned scholar had to take the permission prior from the caretaker of the library system, which was a time-consuming process. Literature orientation after emerging nation technologies. With the passage of time, nation technologies have reached at the threshold of the academics and the libraries, which could really become the cause to change the orientation of both systems. The libraries in the environment of information and communication technology have undergone the drastic transformation in their traditional roles of collecting, organizing and preserving reading materials and disseminating information by conventional procedure and techniques. They have now transcended their four walls and employed latest technologies to meet the emerging and pressing demands of the well-aware seekers of information. It was identified by Singh 2017. The speed of the development of digital contents has increased with jet speed and their accessibility in the public domain has also been started. The technology has given remarkable changes in the pattern of information, storage and retrieval advancement. But with these facilities, the issues of the copyright have also been raised in front of the scholars and stakeholders. Broadly speaking, by copyright is meant an exclusive, legally secured right to publish and sell the substance and form of literary, musical, dramatic, artist works, authors and website contents. Any person who reproduces the work of the original author without his prior permission violates his or her right called copyright. The same principle applies to making of copies of a record. The Indian Copyright Act grants exclusive grant right over his or work to the author during lifetime and 60 years after death. But under the heading of fair dealing and copying by libraries, documentation and information centers under specified conditions, making of photocopies and micro recording of documents for the purpose of research and private study does not tantamount to be an infringement of the copyright. Let's discuss the role of Google in making the easy access and availability of material. After Google, it has been noticed that availability of digital and electronic contents has become easier. With the availability of digital and electronic contents, the institutions have started to create their electronic repository containing curriculum, syllabi, newspapers, clipping, dissertations, theses, and research and review papers published by faculty members. Such type of the repositories are really the witness of the web revolution. Most academic institutions as of now are working on the same concept and developing their curricula through online and making accessible in public domain. It won't be an exaggeration to say that the latest technologies are really powerful tool to change the orientation of academic societies and research activities, but many new and unaddressed issues and challenges have been put forth in front of the academics, which need to be addressed without delay. In information and communication technology era, the most prominent issue has been raised, that is plagiarism. Origin of the word plagiarism. The word plagiarism came from the Latin plagiarus, meaning kidnapper. In academic, the same is known as academic dishonesty or similarity index. The globalization of the world educational systems unveil the plagiarism as of now is more rampant among scholars. Hayes and Introna 2005 indicated in their study some of the plagiarism categories posed to students in a Master of Science program at Lancaster University. Management school regarding copying of work as mentioned below is copied a paragraph or more word for word once or more. Next, never copied a paragraph or more word for word. And third one is judge such copying as not cheating or the trivial cheating. In the 21st century, the electronic publishing became the dominant form of scholarly communication. The scholarly material is available in the public domain with easy access even on a single platform. Therefore, the copying of data is very easy. It has been observed many studies that Generation Z scholars, Generation Z means the scholars who are 25th year old, need information by any means. They are less concerned with the ethics, copyright and plagiarism issues. Hence, the plagiarism is a burning issue nowadays among us, the academic societies. The digital world highly influenced from a plague of plagiarism. Ma et al. 2018 state that the internet is having substantial value in scholars' lives. It is affecting everyone in modern education as scholars need current information for their research core area. Internet keeps updated to scholars, providing enormous amounts of information. It also contributes to ethics deterioration among scholars. The author feels that as the next gen has increasingly easy access to the internet in their lives, literature has revealed that in recent years, more and more young people at school are participating in cheating, and things are getting worse each year. Definitions of plagiarism. While many definitions of plagiarism exist, most agree fundamentally with the following version from the US Department of Health and Human Services Office of Research Integrity, ORI. As a general working definition, ORI considers that plagiarism to include both the theft or misappropriation of intellectual property and the substantial unattributed textual copying of another work. Second one is plagiarism using another words or ideas without appropriate attribution or without following citation conventions. And next, plagiarism or when students copy others' work and pass it off as their own is a serious form of academic misconduct. But as a layman definition, the meaning of the plagiarism is that when you take the materials of another one and quote it the same in your own research work without citing the original source of the information, this is the serious and very simple definition of the plagiarism. And further one is, plagiarism is described as an unrecognized utilization of someone's new idea, expression, text. The utilization of someone's new idea, expression and text without acknowledgement, honesty, trust, fairness, respect and responsibility is the backbone and foundation of academic integrity. Objectives. After undergoing the previous studies, it has been observed that in India academic context, the work on plagiarism is negligible. Even the concept is still underprivileged, as could not define that how to deal with the same in complex digital society. Moreover, the awareness among the research scholars regarding this concept is up to the literary meaning only. Considering these facts and for the purpose, the following objectives are formulated. To explain the present state of plagiarism in different academic fields, the purpose of the presentation today. Second one is to elicit the factors influencing the incidents of plagiarism. Third one is to know how to deal with plagiarism by using the deterrence tools. Fourth one is to study the role of library to combat with plagiarism in digital era. Types of plagiarism. Plagiarism is not a single term. It comprises with many concepts. Further to understand its basics, the scholars have to undergo with the different types of plagiarism. Among many kinds of plagiarism, few important one types are as under, which surely help to understand, explain the concept. One is exact copy plagiarism, means copying sentence in exact and in substantial phrase from a source without acknowledging the original source of information or proper attribution. Number two, modified plagiarism. From its literary meaning, it is understood that when any scholar takes a sentence from any source of information and changing few words. Third one is style plagiarism. Imitate the reasoning, style or concept of others, author, even the copied text fully paraphrased. And fourth one is metaphor plagiarism. Copying someone else's metaphors in describing a particular subject. And fifth one is idea plagiarism. This is very serious form of plagiarism. Under this, if anyone steals the idea of another person, whether it is a novel, idea, theory, formula or solution, the concern will trap. Plagiarism as of now is an overwhelming in the academic and research activities, not only in India, even all over the world. And for further research, this is wide area and having emphatic space and scope, which surely will help in understanding the basics. In fact, every ins and outs of the same. Therefore, it is indispensable to identify the factors which instigate the scholar to commit the plagiarism during their research activities. Some previous studies have identified the following factors which seem responsible. Now, let's discuss the factors which are contributing to plagiarism. Love and Simmons, 1998, identified two broad factors influencing plagiarism based on extensive interviews with master's degree students. External contributing factors may be pressure, may be grade pressure, or time pressure, or the task pressure. And second one is the professor pressure. And second type of contributing factor is internal contributing factors. Negative personal attitude of the concerned scholar, lack of awareness, lack of competence, negligency, educational conditioning, language skill, cultural background, gender, subject being studied, issue with time management, not able to understand the importance of fair research or academic integrity, and conduct research for sake of promotion only. Skelson and Newman, 2002, identified six factors contributing to the incident of plagiarism: lack of awareness, personal attitude, availability of internet resources, pressure, institutional features, the lack of competence. Lack of awareness, where students do not fully understand what constitutes plagiarism or what the penalties for its detection are. They may not see it as a problem. Personal attitudes, positive or negative attitudes, and willingness to expend effort will be reflected in the incidence of plagiarism. Since cheating may be seen as a suitable, if risky, alternative to hard work, internet facilities simplified the process of cut and paste from internet sources. Lack of competencies, lack of confidence in the completing the assignment, pressure task, time, and family pressure are also acknowledged as potential contributors to plagiarism. Institution, the higher education institutes are showing keen interest in curbing the plagiarism activities, as accusation of plagiarism exposes the concern. HEI, HEI means higher educational institutions. With research activities, plagiarism is on priority. Even HEI has already been declared that without plagiarism status report, no thesis would be accepted for awarding. This is the nice step taken by the HEIs. Even University Grants Commission is also very serious and notified a notification in 2018 in Gazette of India Extraordinary. Institution having the significant role in curbing the plague activities even has to organize behavioral ethical workshop and writing ethics for teachers and scholars so that things may be resolved at initial level. As many studies depicted that maximum incidents of plagiarism have been committed due to personal negative attitude and lack of writing ethics. This is very important. As of now, the concerned scholars, they are not very much familiar with the language, that's why they are committing the plagiarism. Plagiarism does not seem always the violation of copyright. It may occur whether the intextual material having the legal protection or not. For taking any material from any source, the attribution is mandate. Otherwise, it might be the part of plagiarism. If anyone traps under such kind of incident, the penalties vary with the policy discretion of the concerned institution authorities. Plagiarism in complex digital society copying from internet. Students take it as granted and turn the copied material into meaningful material and win award without acknowledging the original source. One study has been conducted in UAE with 2,600 students, and it came with the result that tertiary level students in the UAE found that just over 40% considered cutting and pasting from the internet as either trivial cheating or not cheating at all. The attitudes of UAE students are similar to those of other students around the world. Let's know about the deterrence / plagiarism tools which are available for checking the similarity index to curb and control the plagiarism during research activities. Every academic institutions are being done copious efforts, even taking utmost care and using different types of techniques like conducting the workshop on citation, bibliography and ethics of research. In fact, scholars are being aware that plagiarism is punitive element also. It is not only the ethical issue, it has also become punitive element. After observing the seriousness of the concept, some agencies have taken initiative and consequently few prominent deterrence tools emerged. The few prominent names are as under. One is Turn It In, second is Urkun, third one is EVE, fourth one is W Copy Find, fifth one is My Dropbox, sixth one is Cross Check, seventh one is I Authenticate, and eighth one is Word Check, and ninth one is Check for Plug, and many more. The software are working. Some software are offering their services on payment basis, some are on freely basis. Landwith and Rizki 2018 identified these services usually provide the facility to measure the level of similarity between scholar work and material accessed publicly online. The objective of the deterrence tools is to curb the plagiarism whether the severity of similarity is less or more. However, before uploading the academic and research contents on the web, it has to be ensured that the contents are originally one and free from plagiarism. For the same, contents need to be checked by using the anti-plagiarism software. Implementation of anti-plagiarism measures in Indian university has gained importance in view of the mandatory revised UGC regulations for the award of PhD and MPhil degrees. It is investigated in these regulations that each and every academic institution of higher education will make proper assignments to check the plagiarism status before awarding master and doctoral degrees. The mandatory plagiarism check has been integrated into the academic regulations of most of the universities. The universities are required to select and approve anti-plagiarism software at the institution level with policies and procedure of plagiarism check. Many free and paid countermeasurements are plagiarism to exist. However, issue is to store the upload document permanently in the repository of the concerned tool, which leads to increase the level of similarity of the same document when anyone uploads second time. Guidelines on plagiarism. Many studies have been observed that scholars observe plagiarism as a transgression against their common intellectual efforts, but on the other hand, it has also been realized that it must be addressed as the huge countless digital contents are available in the public domain with easy access keys and the facility of copy paste. The use of unethical practices in academics is not uncommon. The information and library network has created an ETD repository of Indian theses, namely Shodh Ganga repository. To participate in the same, the concerned university has to sign MOU with InfliBNet. Thereafter, the universities have to send the soft copies of their theses for uploading into Shodh Ganga repository. The contents of these theses must be free from plagiarism and original one. And for their checking, anti-plagiarism software, namely Urkun, has been provided to member universities. Red and Wesley 2018 depicted that a sound and seamless policy must be framed at institutional universities at the level of regulatory public governing bodies so that issues of plagiarism must be addressed at very initial stage and a plagiarized free environment may be given to scholars. Without policy, scholars were taking it as normal activity and considering the same as victimless crime. This is very serious concern here. If any time caught, therefore, to bring the uniformity in the level of similarity index among all level research activities in the country, The University Grants Commission, UGC, has notified a notification in the Gazette of India, namely University Grants Commission Promotion of Academic Integrity and Prevention of Plagiarism in Higher Educational Institutions Regulation 2018. Under this regulation, UGC has defined each and every thing like academic integrity, author, commission, common knowledge, degree, departmental academic integrity panel, faculty, higher education institution, information, institutional academic integrity panel, notification, plagiarism, program, researcher, script, source, staff, student, university and year. Further, duties of higher education institutions wide which it is mandated that to curb the plagiarism, awareness and training programs need to be organized time to time so that scholars may take precaution in anticipation and self-conduct fair research. In fact, this is the duty of the concerned HEI to frame a soundless policy, sound and seamless policy on the plagiarism and be notified from the concerned regulatory body so that the same may work as and when it does recall. Policy will give the freedom to scholar to release the research, not to be afraid from the accusation of plagiarism. Attitude of modern scholars about intellectual property, ownership. Internet savvy scholars who admit at research level have fundamentally different attitude to ownership intellectual. Our definition and approach to plagiarism must also be changed. However, this must be done without losing the insistence on the intellectual struggle with ideas, which is the hallmark of true education. The institutions must redouble their efforts to provide a framework within which issues of academic dishonesty may be explored and addressed seamlessly. Academic integrity is not something innate. It is something that needs to be learned. The greater awareness of open access and various community-based open resources developed through knowledge sharing in the current technological environment have made a plethora of online e-resources freely available on the internet. The use of online resources for academic use comes under the purview of various national and international laws, rules and regulations. The ethical practices how to use someone else's digital work must be followed. It involves proper attribution in a standard way according to the copyright and licensing restrictions attached to a particular digital object. To avoid all these issues require great awareness of the academic community about the plagiarism. Types of plagiarism, policy and guidelines, causes and consequences of plagiarism. Imparting such information to students is now an integral part of curriculum in the university so that at initial stages, the students may easily aware from this and take care during their higher research activities. Lastly, if we see that to ensure the quality education for present and coming generation, the Government of India has been putting countless efforts since independence and funding public funded different advanced projects which might have been proved milestone. In this series, in 2009, National Mission on Education through Information and Communication Technology has started a joint venture of MHRD and CCEA, Cabinet Committee of Economic Affairs. Under this program, so far more than 400 universities and 14,000 colleges have been provided 1 Gbps connectivity. In the same way, Indian Institutes of Technology, Bombay has started the program Center for Distance Education Engineering Programs, CDEEP, where the virtual classrooms is created and interaction through real-time interactive satellite technology. IIT Kanpur has developed Braspati, an open-source e-learning platform. Moreover, Indian National Digital Library in Engineering, Science and Technology, MHRD, and University Grants Commission, InfoNet has set up. These programs are providing to be milestone in conducting the qualitative research activities and promoting technical education. Shodh Ganga and Shodh Gangotri are another one example in this category. Due to availability and accessibility of huge contents in public domain, the easy cut paste has come into existence and more familiar among the scholars. Thereby, the scholars are being trapped easily. Consequently, the issues of plagiarism are on its scaffold. The Indian academics are in transition phase, thereby hybrid system has developed. With this hybrid environment, the plagiarism cases are being more complicated as the deduction tools which will match the text of uploaded documents with the data which is available only on web. But what about the text which is still unavailable on web? In that case, the report of the plagiarism shall not be 100% genuine. Even the scholars may be trapped after enclosing the report of deduction tool. Therefore, the relevance of the presentation is that to create the awareness among scholars towards the basics of the concept along with its deterrence tools and factors contributing. In addition, offering empathetic remedies as suggestive measures to overcome and help in designing a sound and seamless policy so that at initial level, the same may be conveyed to the scholars and fair and authentic research may be conducted without confronting any litigation. Thank you.